Hello mga students, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Kagaya nga ng sinasabi ko, ano, kung anong oras nyo ito pinapanood. Hello sa inyong lahat. Now, ang next topics, dalawang topics po natin ay medyo may kahabaan. So, unang-una sa lahat class, I'd like to apologize, no, if I will be asking an extension of your time because we need to cover everything at makapture natin lahat ng mga presentations na ginawa ninyo. Ang dalawang chapters kasi na pag-uusapan natin ngayon ay medyo interesting. At because interesting siya, no, at medyo mahaba-haba yung naging discussion, ang isang presenter, the group that was in charge in presenting change management, it took them around 1.5 hours, 1 hour 20 minutes kung hindi ako nagkakamali. Samantalang yung in charge naman sa pagpe-present ng chapter 12 on project management ay inabot naman ng 2 oras. So, kumbaga, 2 hours plus 1.5. So, sabihin na natin na 3.5 hours ang presentations alone lang po nila, no? So, I'll try to minimize my summary, my discussions here para naman, ano, hindi masyado mahaba yung magiging extension natin. Although, siguro at a minimum, nasa 30 minutes pa rin naman ito, class. Another one, I'd like to commend everyone. Marami akong pansin sa reporters na ito, no, that they are great presenters, hindi lamang good presenters but great speakers, no? Hindi nakakaantok. Hindi nakakaantok yung iba. Yung iba, ano, hindi lahat. So may mga iba talaga na magaling sa pagsasalita at ano, no, nakaka-attract ng atensyon ng mga manunood. So I commend you all, no? And also yung mga iba rin po, ano, from the previous presenters, from the previous speakers. Now allow me to share my screen. Ipakita ko lang muna po, ano, yung pasadahan lang muna natin yung chapter 11 on change management. And eto po kasi yung mga naging presentation. Okay, naging presentation ng group na in charge of chapter 11. Kung makikita po ninyo, ay inabot po ito ng 61 slides. Pero ganito lang, class, ano, ang pinag-usapan lang po natin dito sa chapter 11, either you look from the PDF material or you look at their PowerPoint or you are watching from their video lectures, and I suggest, no, I would really encourage you all to watch the video lectures para hindi naman sayang, ano, yung mga presentations po nila. At sinatsaga ko din po ito, no, because I am also checking sino sa mga students yung magaling magsalita at sino yung malaman, ano, at hindi lamang po nagpe-present for purpose of presentation, for purpose of compliance requirements. Okay? A class dito sa chapter 11, ito po ang mga aaralin po ninyo. We have different models or approaches in change management kasi. Also, syempre, in-explain ng inyong mga kaklase, ano, ano ba yung change management. But in the context of different models, meron po dyang tatlo. The first one is that of Kotter. Asa na nga yung kay Kotter? Yung 8. Okay, eto. Tumagpas ako. This one. The 8-step model. Dito, sinasabi nila that this is Kotter's 8-step model to transforming an organization. Sa book, ano, this is what we call the 8-step process for leading change. And this is the model from Kotter. Kotter is the ano, no, author. Siya yung may gawa nitong modelo na ito. At makikita naman po ninyo dito yung 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. At in-explain naman po ito ng mga reporters, no? Another one, we have the Lewins 3-step change model. Sir, ano yung Lewins 3-step model? Ito yung diniscuss ni Joey Lin, ano, on unfreeze, change, and refreeze. Okay? Ang tawag po natin dyan at yung nakalagay sa libro is this is the 3-step change model. Okay? We also have, ayan, no, si Kurt Lewins. Kasi siya yung author naman ito. Siya yung may akda. And we also have this one, no, the PDCA approach. Ito yung kay Demings naman. Demings model of plan, do, check, and act. And of course, no, ito naman po ay nabigyan ng stage siya ng ating mga reporters. Okay? Isa pa sa mga pag-uusapan at aaralin po ninyo dito sa chapter na ito is on project risk assessment and risk failure. Kasama na rin po dito yung mga risk assessment techniques. Okay? Yung risk assessment, medyo hindi na po ito bago sa atin, ano? Hindi lamang po on the context of operational auditing, but even yung ating auditing and assurance concepts, principles, because yung ating ano, no, audit process involves risk assessment. We are identifying risks, di ba? And providing measures, controls para maiwasan natin itong mga risk na ito coming from the point of view of the management. Although dito, ang focus naman natin is on the project itself, no? Project risk assessment. So, ito ay specific sa isang project engagement. Hindi yung for the, who, ano, no, company-wide or organization-wide. Per project po ito. At ano din itong risk of failure na tinatawag. Okay? Another one, yung understanding. Asa na yon? This one, no? Understanding and manage and managing resistance to change. Kasi class, no, when we are talking about change management, how do we manage change? How do we deal with it? Now, mamaya, meron akong ipapakita sa inyo, ano? I will be citing it from one of the materials that I am, ano, no, giving to my students, although it is on the point of view, it is on the context of auditing in a CIS environment or yung IT audit. May ika-capture lang ako doon kasi yung change management na pag-uusapan din ito sa ibang mga subjects, sa ibang mga topics eh. Halimbawa, yung ipipresent ako sa inyo maya-maya is on the ano, no, system development lifecycle or yung SDLC when we are talking of the change control. So I will show it to you. Ano. So dito, meron tayong tinatawag na understanding and managing resistance to change. Kasi marami po, lalong-lalo na yung mga older people, ano, sa organization, medyo challenge po sa kanila yung ano, no, pag-adjust sa process, even sa management, sa mga tao, ano. So, paano bang ginagawa, no? What do we need? If we are the ones that initiates the change, how do we help these people understand, especially yung mga resistance, yung mga kontra, no? Lagi naman kasi may opposition sa lahat ng bagay. Patapos lang ng ating election, so merong mga pros and cons. So kahit saan, hindi po diyan ligtas yung organization, no? Maybe it's on the process, maybe it's in the people, maybe because of the circumstance, no, that will ano, no, warrant a need to effect a change. So there will be a change that ano, no, sabi nga nila, di ba, change is constant. Change is the only thing that is. How do we cope up with this? No, hindi kasi pwede na resist at resist lang tayo. And sometimes ang mga change kasi sa organization ay for the good, no, rather than for the worst. Pero may mga ano din kasi maling desisyon na is na maging mapabuti yung lagay ng office, ng management, no, ng organization, mas napapatuloy, no, naaalanganin because maybe may mali sa execution. Okay? We are also talking about the people, process, and technology. At eto class, no, as I was studying, as I was listening to the presentation, asa na ba yun? Eto, yung tinatawag natin na big three. So, the people, process, and technology. O para mabilis ninyo itong kabisaduhin, ano, PPT, PowerPoint, no? People, process, and technology. Actually, when they are presenting it, ang pinakatumatak sa akin dito sa kanilang discussion ay yung hiring process, no? And understanding the hiring process. Because before, when I was still in the private sector, no, our company is a manpower service provider. So, since I was a corporate internal auditor, I am very much aware of the hiring process. So, dito, ano, in-elaborate nila ito, papaano ba? From the recruitment, no? Asa na nga ba yun? Ito, no? They break down, break down po nila yung hiring process. Kapag may kinakailangan na tao, they will provide ano, position request. Tapos, the management will approve it. And then, of course, the job description should be available. Then, the process of selection, no, yung recruitment, mga exams, no, interviews, exams, hanggang sa job offer at sa pagtanggap na sa umpisa. Okay? So, they elaborated on it. But of course, please remember that we are not talking about recruitment, we are not talking about human resources here, but we are talking about this big three, no? People, process, and technology. We're only talking about the people and the process aspect, but of course, no, meron po tayong technology. But allow me to let the presenter, the reporter, explain it to you, ano, as you go along with that, with their presentations. Okay? And this is another one, pang kasama pa po doon sa kanilang present is yung dysfunctions. Although ito kasi class ay kumbaga subcategory, no, sa libro, this is included as part, no, of the topic on the big three. But Mr. Jello, Mr. Cano, explained it to us naman. Okay? So ito po yung nilalaman nung kanilang presentation. Medyo may kahabaan because they elaborated it. So please give time, no? Please spare some of your time to finish the reports. Okay? Now, in relation to this change management, meron lang akong gustong idagdag. And allow me to pick it up from one of my file. This one, okay? Ayan, I know you are already seeing it, no? Because sabi ko nga kanina, as part of the system development lifecycle or software development lifecycle yata ito, na pinag-uusapan ko dito, ang isang aspeto dito ay yung change control. And when we are talking of change control, meron tayong aspeto ng change management. And although this is on the context of an IT environment, allow me to read this, no? Because this is still applicable. Change management is the overall process that ensures effective changes. So, pause na natin doon. Yun na yun, whether in an IT environment or in a not-so-IT environment. So, ito ay isang overall process na sinisigurado, no, na effective yung change, yung application, no, yung ating transition from one process to another in terms of kung process man yung pinag-uusapan natin. And please remember that the purpose of change management is to minimize the likelihood of disruption and unapproved changes as well as errors. Kasi hindi biro po na mayroong changes sa organization. Marami na nga yung mga medyo alanganin, resistant to change, at hindi nila alam kung ano yung magiging epekto nito sa kanila. Baka mamaya automation pala yung change management at kawalan ng trabaho ang kapalit nito. So definitely they will be resisting it because trabaho nila yung nakasalalay. Okay, pero we want to minimize the disruption and unapproved changes kasi kinakailangan na yung approved change lang ang may effect. Baka mamaya may mga makalusot na unapproved changes. Kaya nga sa mga reading, no, i-apply lang natin sa paggawa ng batas. Meron tayong lower house, meron tayong upper house. So kapag may gagawing batas, kinakailangan na kung halimbawa magagaling ito sa House of Representatives, sa mga congressmen, okay, i-ratify ito, no? I-check ito ng Senate, tapos kung may mga sarili silang version, maaaring ipag-merge, no, hanggang magkaroon ng approval at maging okay sila, ma-approve yung bill na yon at ipapa-approve sa president. So merong may check and balance. So we don't want to have unnecessary changes, yung mga unapproved, no, at maiwasan yung mga errors. Okay? A change management process is one that consists of analysis, implementation, and review of all changes. So this is a process, no, a step-by-step process. Okay. Now, another one, no, that I want to highlight here is this. Ang change management system, of course, a change management is a system. It involves an orderly process, no, that consists of the following controls. Although we are talking here on an IT environment, ito po ay applicable naman kasi hindi naman talaga specific dito, no? Number one, processing of request changes, okay, or the change request process. Number two, assessment of impact by the change, or ang tinatawag natin dito ay impact assessment. Control process over changes. Revision to documentations and procedures, no? Kung may kinakailangang i-revise, okay, edi update natin yung mga yon. Authorization of maintenance changes. Ito yung tinatawag natin na authorized maintenance. Number six, policy for new software releases. Although ito applicable kapag may mga software na involved, no, may mga systems, system implementation, no, may mga implement na kailangan. process for distributing software, kung may kinakailangan sa software, no? And then yung emergency change process. Although majority dito ay applicable regardless of the type of the change that we need to effect sa organization. Okay? So another one that I want to include, no, yung change management tools and procedures, no? The following are possible areas to consider in developing a change management procedure. Document the reason for change. Oh, bakit? Although ito ano ay napag-uusapan din naman doon sa mga models na in-explain ng inyong mga kaklase, ng inyong mga kabatch. Identify who is requesting the change, yung initiator, no? Formalize who will make the change. Sino yung process owner, no? Define how the change will be made. Document back out procedures should the need arise. Okay? Ito yung mga backup natin, back out procedures, no? Assess the risk of failure and impact of the change. O ito yung dinidiscuss din kanina. Or doon sa presenters, no, yung risk assessment, project risk assessment, and risk of failure. Aid in communicating with those affected by the change. Identify, eto, kinakailangan for disaster recovery. Okay, disaster recovery considerations. Identify conflicts between multiple changes and enhance management awareness of all of the above. Naging multiple choice na, all of the above. Ayan. So, I hope, no, makadagdag ito at mas ma-elaborate ito yung presentations na ginawa ng inyong mga kaklase. Okay? So that will be my addition pagdating po dito sa change management on the first reporter. Now, dako naman po tayo doon sa presentation nung project management. Okay? Ito naman po ano ang report coming from the BSA 3B2 of the following personnel on project management. Alam niyo klase, ano, itong project management na topic, kung isi-summarize ko ito, ano, ito lang naman yan. No? They explain the project phases from the initiation to the planning to the execution, closing, monitoring, and control. Although, coming from the reference kasi yung libro, meron discussion doon the yung mga keys to success and reason some IT projects fail. Okay, although ito medyo related na rin sa IT audit eh. Although of course, no, pag operations audit, hindi naman kasi tayo limited sa process. Eh, if the project relates to ano, no, information technology sa mga infrastructure, eh maaaring scope pa rin naman 'yan ng internal audit for operations audit. Kasi marami sa mga companies sa ngayon ay hindi naman na ano, no, traditional yung approach, marami diyan yung technology driven na. So, marami sa mga processes ay highly dependent na sa systems, okay, sa information technology, sa IT infrastructure. So, hindi pwede na iskipan natin yan. Kasi, uy, pang IT naman yan. Eh. Okay, and then also, na-discuss po dito sa chapter na ito, yung project selection, project matrix, and project software. Sa ngayon, medyo napapadali na yung buhay ng ibang mga ano, no, project management personnel or on the point of view of the internal auditors, no, because marami na po tayong mga project management tools. Okay, alam niyo ano, before, way back in 2018, before the ano, no, pandemic, meron akong binili na ano, no, binili na PowerPoint, ano ba ito? Infografia, no? At napansin ko, merong isang ano dun eh, PowerPoint template for project management. And allow me to share this to you again. No, pakita ko lang po. Kasi doon ano, may mga insights din tayo na makukuha in terms of the, although these are slides, no, these are different slides, pero makikita po ninyo na kung ano yung diniscuss sa project management ay nandoon din po, no, naka-incorporate din. Although maaari kasi na different authors will define or make different approaches on project management. Pero kasi halimbawa, etong slide na ito, kung titignan po ninyo, ano, initiation, the project management is divided into 5. Initiation, planning, execution, control, and closure. Diba? Familiar. For the initiation, the project charter. For the planning, yung scope, yung breakdown, o tapos Gantt chart. Eh, kasi normally, ano, in terms of project management, pinakagamit na gamit natin is the Gantt chart. Kasi dito nakalagay yung timeline. Okay? Kailan yung umpisa, kailan matatapos, paano ito magiging connected or related sa ibang mga processes, especially if we are treating different procedures or different steps in the project, no? And then yung execution, forecast, project status, progress tracking, okay? Pagdating sa control, activity tracking, goal tracking, budget tracking, and pagdating naman sa closure, syempre, pagtapos ng ating project, the project analysis and project report. Okay? You can also see different, although templates po ito, ano? Meron din po ako dito ang gustong ipakita sa inyo. Okay? This one also. Ito. Because we can present the timeline in this phase, no? The project plans, stage plans, team plans, different stages. So, pwedeng ganyan po natin ito i-present. These are tools, no? What else? Ito, waterfall. Asan na ba yung waterfall na yon? Kasi may nakita ako doon sa presentation or sa book, no? Speaking of yung mga waterfall, okay? So, pa-waterfall siya. Dito, naka-present in terms of project timeline, ano? Plan, papuntang create, papuntang review, papuntang release. Okay? Dito naman, in terms of the portfolio, in terms of the project, in terms of the work, may different trackers tayo, ano? Okay? So, it can be presented differently. Ito, a guide, no? In terms of project management. Create a career plan, network, be a thought leader, wear many hats, be a great communicator. No? So, may mga guide naman po ito, no? For example, in create a career plan, gamitin mo ang skills mo as a project manager to plan the goals and develop schedule with steps that you get there. Okay? Involve yourself with trade groups and organizations. Be a thought leader. Use your skills and experience. Wear many hats, no? Project managers are involved in every aspect of a project. Ibig sabihin, hindi pwede na taga-oversee ka lang. Dapat meron ka rin involvement sa details, no? Hindi yung taga-utos ka lang, taga-command ka lang. Okay? And then, be a great communicator, no? Communication is key to everything. Kaya nga, meron tayong mga monitoring, no? Okay, so pasadahan lang natin yung iba-ibang mga approaches dito. Ito naman, more of initiation and conception, planning, launch and execution, monitoring and control, and project closure. Although maybe, you know, different terminologies yung ginagamit natin, pero yung concept, yung approach, yung process pare-parehas. In this approach naman, makikita po ninyo, for the initiation and conception, no? Define project goals, create project brief, yung summary. For the planning, no? Ayun, yung scope and budget din. Yung deadlines, yung team roles, communication plan, milestones. Kasi normally, ang projects, nahati-hati natin ito into different milestones. For the launch and execution, no? Budget management, resource planning, status reports. For the monitoring and control, yung project goals, quality of deliverables, team performance. And then, pagdating sa project closure, no? We have to celebrate. May celebration. Siyempre, natapos na yung project eh. Retrospective meeting, project closure report. So, parang mga status meeting. No? Completion meeting. Wrap up. Okay? So, there you go. At marami pa pong iba. Okay? Different persons, no? Present it differently. Different managers present it differently. Because, you know, class, itong project management, hindi lang naman natin ito magagamit sa subject natin. Magagamit po ninyo ito kahit sa eskwelahan. Because, on how, on what aspect. You treat your subjects as a project, no? And you plan them accordingly. Paano ba yung mga approaches ng mga prof ninyo? Ano yung mga requirements niya sa subject? Okay? Ano yung atake niya sa kanyang pagtuturo? So you can also plan. If you have you are running for honor, you are a scholar, meron kang scholarship na hinahabol. So you present milestones, no? You present your plans, no? Para aware ka anong kinakailangan mong gawin. Okay, in terms of the execution wise, no? And then status progress, no? Pagdating ng mga prelim grades, midterm grades, kung medyo alanganin ako, paano ko ito ika-catch up? Okay? Communication with my professors, no? So marami pa pong iba. Okay? So, there you go. These are the relevant topics, no? Maganda po itong topic na ito. Pasensyahan nyo na medyo may kahabaan, no? Sabi ko nga, yung chapter 11 on change management, 1 hour, 20 minutes, around something around like that timeline, ano, no? Time frame. Tapos etong project management mas mahaba. Okay? 2 hours. But then kaya naman 'yan, class, no? Pagbigyan na natin yung etong mga kaklase para mabigyan natin ng hustisya yung kanilang mga reports. Okay? So, thank you very much. Hanggang dito na lamang po yung aking summary lectures on these two topics, no? So, baka magulat kayo, mahaba-haba ito. Meron pang mas mahaba. Yung chapter 13, ano? Ay yung grupo nila Mr. Santos. Okay? 3 hours din yun. Although, yung panghuli naman ay 30 minutes lang. So, ayan. Dito muna tayo, no? Sa dalawang topics na ito. And let me know if you have any questions. I hope maging to ano no malaki yung maitulong nito sa inyo, hindi lamang for purpose of this subject, no, but on your daily lives, no, because we are talking of something, a topic that can be ano no, that can be applied on our student life. Okay, so thank you very much. Hanggang dito na po tayo sa summary lecture na ito. I'll see you soon through my video lectures. Bye bye.